Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome back. This is Infamous here, coming back with another build video for the Elder Scrolls Online. If you're looking for PvP content, especially for the Battlegrounds, look no further than battleofthebuild.com. It's a great source. It's a dedicated site for people who enjoy PvP, especially for NoCP and Battlegrounds. It's a site created by yours truly, Infamous. You can feel free to check me out on Twitch at InfamousNYC. And of course, there's a plethora of builds here dedicated to PvP. The build that I'm coming back with today is called Blood Magic. It is a necromancer build designed around for healing. Again, you can see the stats right here. 28k magicka, 25k health, 12k stam. These are regens with a pot. Spell damage, spell critical. You can see the resistances here. And this build is, of course, for the necromancer class. This build is dedicated towards healing. As you can see here, we're utilizing rapid regen, renewing undeath, necrotic potency, hexproof, inner light, and of course life giver for your ultimate. Back bar, we're utilizing the agony totem, healing orb, spirit guardian, structured entropy, of course, for major sorcery, summoner's armor, and on the back bar is kind of a flex spot with glacial colossus. In terms of the sets, utilizing Black Rose. The reason being is because if you're going to be playing a support healer build, either in no CP, CP, open world, or battlegrounds, you're going to be focused by a lot of players, so you're going to need a decent amount of health stamina, as well as stamina recovery, and of course a good amount of magicka recovery. I liked Black Rose particularly because it takes really good advantage of the Constitution passive, which returns stamina and magicka every 4 seconds when you take damage. Again, you're a healer. The moment people see you healing, they're going to focus you because you're the primary person that's going to be keeping your team alive. So you're going to be taking damage. You're going to want a healthy amount of regen so that you can utilize your abilities, spam them when necessary, and of course have enough of an HP so that you can take an ultimate or two and still be able to come back. And of course, you're going to want a good amount of physical spell resistance and critical resistance so that you basically don't go down in a fight, because when you go down, the rest of the team goes down. So this is why I went, my first set was with the Black Rose. It gives you back magicka and stamina, as well as giving you a healthy amount of magicka, stamina, and magicka recovery. And of course, it says there, you gain a little bit of spell damage, and of course it increases your max magic and stamina restored from the Constitution passive by 35%. The next set that we're looking at is going to be the Bloodthorn set. Of course, this is acquired in the Overland in Glenumbra. So this is a five piece Black Rose coupled with five pieces of Bloodthorn. Again, the reason being is that you're going to be utilizing heavy attacks, light attacks, direct damage, and of course it's going to be rewarding you with both magicka and stamina. Of course, once every 5 seconds, it gives you a good amount of spell damage, spell recovery, and magicka recovery. And then, of course, magicka and stamina every time you basically light attack or heavy attack. The reason that this is important is because, again, you're going to be CC breaking, situational dodge roll, blocking, and, of course, spamming abilities that you want to over-sustain as much as you comfortably can while having decent amount of spell damage so that your abilities have a good tooltip to them. The other two-piece that we're using is Bloodspawn. Bloodspawn's going to give you 129 stamina recovery, and of course when you take damage there's a 6% chance for you to gain 14 ultimate, as well as increase your physical and spell resistance by 6450 for the next 6 seconds. And of course it has a 6 second cooldown. The reason being that I chose these sets is because necromancer ultimates are fairly expensive. This is a flex spot. Of course you want to utilize your life giver. Of course, in a pinch, it's a really strong ultimate. Your primary sources of healing is going to come from rapid regeneration and renewing undeath. Necrotic potency is going to be there so that your stamina, so that your ultimate regen is maintained high, so that you can take advantage either of a healing ultimate or assisting your teammates with the glacial colossus that stuns on the third hit, as well as doing damage, as well as providing your team with the major vulnerability so that everybody hit by the colossus will receive an additional 30% damage. So we have a defensive utility ability as an ultimate, and then we have an offensive utility ability that we can utilize. And of course, for this particular race, I am a Nord. I do feel that Nord is a really good racial choice for the Necromancer, because you want, it lacks mobility, so you want the extra tankiness that Nord gives. You want the extra stamina for CC breaking and dodge rolling, and of course the HP you want, of course, because you want to be able to have a healthy pool so that you can take damage, you can take a punch, and you're still alive to support your team. And of course you also get the extra ultimate regen, as well as being immune to frost, to the cold status effects, the chilled status effects, which causes the root from anybody using Wall of Elements, and of course the also the minor damage reduction, the minor maim. The next ability, of course, is Hexproof. This is an awesome ability. This is kind of why you don't need a kind of like a root from like for example Race Against Time, because Hexproof will be able to remove roots and snares, as well as basically any negative status effect on you. It removes four status effects, and of course it costs HP. You want Inner Light for the extra magicka, the magicka recovery, and of course as well as the critical, because you want critical heals, primarily because as your opponents, as your teammates get lower in their HP, because of the near-death experience, your critical bonus is going to go up. So of course you want to have a decent amount of critical. 20 is enough, because we are utilizing heavy armor. And the back bar, I was thinking of going either Sword and Shield or maybe going a different Restowall, but I think Sword and Shield for the extra tankiness is really good. The Agony Totem provides your teammates with minor protection, as well as increasing the amount of damage that your teammates can use when they utilize the synergy. The synergy there will cause an additional 8% via the minor vulnerability, and of course after 2 seconds it will also CC via the fear anybody standing within the agony totem. We're using healing orbs, of course. This is to help our group, supporting them, of course, increasing their regen, because when they utilize the synergy from this ability, it heals everybody. It also restores some of their stamina or magicka, whichever is greater. Excuse me. The other ability that we're using on the back part is called the Spirit Guardian. The Spirit Guardian lasts for 16 seconds. When it dies, it will leave behind a corpse, as well as you healing you for a little bit. The primary purpose of it is that while you have a summon ability basically up, you gain an extra 200 stamina, as well as magicka recovery, as well as the damage reduction from the Spirit Guardian. It absorbs 10% of the damage that you take, which is why we're utilizing this one over the healing version that lasts 8 seconds. That one, it really has a nice heal to it, but our primary heals are going to be coming from Rapid Regen, Renewing on Death, as well as situational use for the Life Giver Ultimate. And of course, healing orbs obviously are going to heal our group. So we're utilizing this to basically help us sustain and keep alive, giving us sustain, and of course giving us that little bit of extra tankiness. On the back bar, we're also utilizing a Structure's Entropy, obviously for the Major Sorcery, the extra HP, a little bit of regen on the back bar, and of course Summoner's Armor is going to reduce the amount of cost whenever after casting this ability. Summoner's Armor will reduce it by 15%, giving us sustain. And of course on the back bar we have Glacial Colossus for the stun, for the major vulnerability, and of course for the damage. For the traits, of course, when going heavy armor, you always want to go reinforced on the chest. We're utilizing 2 pieces of divines for Impen. This is a 5 heavy 2 light build with all points into magicka. We're utilizing tri-stat glyphs on the large pieces, and of course magicka on the small pieces. For the atrio, for the Mundus, we're using the atrio, and of course we're utilizing, for our food buff, we're working with the Clockwork Citrus. This is a decisive staff, and I was thinking of using weakness on the front bar to reduce, I guess, one person's physical as well as spell damage. And of course on the back bar, we're utilizing a Sword and Shield, sturdy shield on the back bar. Not really going to be on the back bar all that often, but when we are, we're utilizing a little bit of extra block cost reduction. Of course the best races would be Nord. Like I said before, Imperial is a really good race because it gives you more stamina, more HP, and of course the cost reduction, as well as whenever you deal direct damage, It restores Magicka, Stamina, and as well as HP. Britain's really good for the cost reduction, for the extra regen, the extra max Magicka, etc. And of course for the extra spell resistance when you have a status effect, which couples really nice with the extra 8% healing that the Necromancer gets whenever it has a negative effect on it. Argonian's really good because it has extra healing done, as well as of course the passive from the potion use. It allows you to use different types of potions and of course still be able to keep your regen high. I put it last because we're going to have really good Magicka and Stamina recovery between just our base recoveries. Black Rose coupled with the Bloodthorn set will give us really high recoveries, especially when we're in combat, which is what you want. My particular opinion, if you're going to be running a support, you really want to over-sustain, especially once you start to get focused by multiple people, whether you're playing in a small man group in open world or whether you're on a team in a battlegrounds. You really want to be able to over sustain so that you can stay alive, and of course so that you can do your job in supporting your teammates as a support healer. This is the Necromancer build. Of course, feel free to check me out on Twitch. I'll probably be playing this build sometime next week. It's going to be a long week of work for me, but I will be looking forward to checking this out. Feel free to check me out on Twitch at InfamousNYC, and of course check out battleofthebuild.com. Whether you're looking for basically a build for every sort of class, I've got numerous builds here. I've played literally almost every single one of these builds live on Twitch. If you have any questions, feel free. I've been playing this game for the better part of 5 years, since the late alphas, early betas. And I'm primarily a PvPer. I do some PvP occasionally, but primarily I'm enjoying the no CP battleground settings. And I've been playing literally probably at this point thousands of battlegrounds. So I really know how to make I really know what it takes to create builds for battlegrounds. And of course there's a wide variety of builds that you can create in the Elder Scrolls Online, which is why I really enjoy this game. And of course making vast types of builds, whether you're looking for tanks, supports, stamina DPS, Magicka DPS, hybrid builds. I've got a hybrid build just for about every single class, and I will be posting more builds. I'm working on putting up my stamina build for the Stamina Nightblade, and then of course I will be posting a healing build for the Templar. And I've already got numerous builds here, whether they're support, tank, DPS, light armor, heavy armor, etc. I did post my Magicka build for the Magicka Sorcerer, and of course you could always feel free to check out the Hybrid Sorcerer. It's a really awesome build. I really enjoyed playing this build. I've streamed it many times. And hybrids are definitely viable. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. Even for the hybrid Magicka DK, there's a medium armor build, as well as of course I'll be posting my older heavy armor hybrid build. But they're all very viable. They all do a lot of damage, and of course I always show my fully buffed specs. Why I created the build is always a little blurb about the kind of the theory crafting behind the build, and typically there's some sort of a gameplay from a previous battleground. Feel free to take a look at battleofthebuild.com. And also there's also some information for those who want to play a werewolf build. And if you're new to the Elder Scrolls Online and you're new to PvP, be sure to check out what are battlegrounds, how to build, PvP tips, and of course you can check out PvP clips to get an idea of how to create builds and what it looks like to play in the battlegrounds. And of course I always do commentary. Like I said, feel free to check out battleofthebuild.com. It's a very great source for people who are looking for competitive battleground builds for the Elder Scrolls Online. I'm Infamous, and I'll check you out next time. Take care, and God bless. Thanks for watching. Feel free to like, comment, and subscribe.